from 2018 to 2021, just the, what you learned and all the things that we went through in that in terms of our evolution there and the growth.
Oh, I learned a lot. Became a really good tire kicker, if you will.
Yeah.
Right. We looked at a ton of deals.
I think like 50 or 60 deals when we put it all together at the end to do like the what we evaluated and what we bid on.
Some really good deals and most really not good deals. Right. And our timing was just about as bad as it could have been getting into the midstream business at that point in time.
Yeah.
You know,
bad or good. I mean, we could have got a deal. Had we got in it maybe a year or two earlier, we may have got something done that was bigger, but it would have not turned out very well.
Yeah, you're right about that. But we learned a lot. Screening deals is what we probably got really, really good at.
Underwriting deals is a skill set.
It is.
And it's one thing to be kind of a part of the team. Like I think on our bios, we say that we've been a part of X amount of billions of dollars of deals and transactions. And a lot of those, we were just a team member. We were like, hey, you're handling the commercial piece of this, or you're handling the due diligence side for your niche. But it's different when you're like the CEO or whatever, the leader of the deal team, and you're actually going to have to underwrite it from start to finish, think about operations, think about the financial side, and then think about putting your own money in it and the risk that you're taking.
And you know, what's interesting is we had two other really good partners in on our midstream team, Jason Fournier and Danny Craig, and we all had a voice.
Yeah.
And sometimes we, you know, a voice would speak up and go, I don't want to do this deal. And three other guys are attacking him going, why not? Why not? Why not?
Right, right.
And in the end, he's probably right.
Yeah.
So and that's the other thing I learned quite a bit about during all of our, you know, going on 9 years or 10 years of this. Listen to your partner.
Right.
And know your partner.
Right.
You know, that's the other thing. And, you know, I don't think that – I think every one of the four of us, at least at some point in time, was singled out, was the lone voice saying, sure, I don't want to do this deal.
Right.
Sometimes, you know, I know that you guys talked me off the ledge a couple of times.
Sure.
And so, it's just having good partnerships is key to any entrepreneurial